Hello students, today we will learn how to add two or more rational numbers. Here, first of all, we should notice that if the two given rational numbers have the denominator in positive or not. If the denominators are not in positive, then first of all, we should convert all the denominators in positive. Then we should add the numbers. In adding the number, we have two cases. In first case, when the given rational numbers have same denominator. In that case, we have to follow this rule. For example, A by B plus C by D. Here both the denominators are same. So we will add their numerator as according to the sign. So A plus C divided by B. That will give you the sum of the both rational number. Here, for example, we have taken 3 by 7 plus 5 by 7. Then LCM of 7 and 7 will be 7. And we will directly add 3 plus 5. That will be equal to 8 by 7. So this will be the result of 3 by 7 plus 5 by 7. Now, when both, in second case, when denominators are not same, when denominators are not same, in that case, what we have to do, when denominator of the given number are unequal, that is not same, in that case, we should take LCM of the given denominators and express each of the given numbers with the LCM as common denominator. When we get the common denominator, then, as we have shown in the first example, according to that rule, we have to just add both the rational number. Here, 4 by 9 plus minus 11 by 27. Here we are observing that both the denominators are different. In first case, denominator is 9, and in second case, denominator is 27. Here, LCM of 9 and 27 will be 27. Now, convert 4 by 9 as, because we have to convert 9 into 27, so multiply 9 into 3 and 4 into 3. That will be equal to 12 by 27. And second number is minus 11 by 27. So, these both numbers can be added in the same manner what we have shown in the example 1. So here 4 by 9 plus minus 11 by 27, that will be equal to 12 by 27 plus minus 11 by 27. Here LCM naturally LCM will be 27 and we will add numerator as according to their sign. So it will be 12 plus bracket minus 11 bracket close. So the result will be equal to 1 by 27. In this manner, we can add any rational numbers having different denominators. Now we will learn the properties of addition of rational number. In this section, in first property, we learn closure property. What is closure property? Closure property states that the sum of any two rational number is always a rational number. The sum of any rational numbers is always a rational number. For example, if A by B is one rational number and C by D is another rational number. When both rational numbers are added, then it is also a rational number. For example, 7 by 13, which is a rational number, is added to 15 by 39, which is also a rational number. Then we get the LCM as 13. Divide 39 by 13, we get 3. Now 7 multiply 3 plus 39 divided by 39 we get cosec as 1. 1 into 15 is equal to 15. Now the result will be 21 plus 15 by 39. That will be equal to 36 by 39. When we bring this rational number to the simplest in a standard form, that will be equal to 12 by 13. So in this way, 12 by 13 is also a rational number. So this law tells us that when we bring this rational number to the simplest in a standard form, that will be equal to 12 by 13. So in this way, 12 by 13 is also a rational number. So this law tells us that when two rational numbers are added, then we always get a rational number. Okay? Now in second property, that is the commutative law. Commutative law tells us that when two rational numbers can be added in any order, two or more rational numbers can be added in any order, but we will get the same result. For example, if A by B is added to C by D, this sum gives the same result as C by D plus A by B. Here, order is changed. Okay? So, when we add both the number in different order, we get the same numbers. Okay? Now, I want to show you the example for this. Hello. Here I have taken some example. For example, 4 by 9 plus 7 by 18. That will be gives the same result as 7 by 18 plus 4 by 9. Here we have just changed the order. Here 4 by 9 in first order, in second order 7 by 18. But here in first order 7 by 18 is there, and in second order 4 by 9. So let us solve LHS. 4 by 9 plus 7 by 18. When we will add the gives, it gives the result equal to 5 by 6. But when we add the LHS, then we get 7 by 18 plus 4 by 9. Here order is changed, but the result is 5 by 6. So here we are observing that in both the cases, the order of the rational numbers have been changed, but we are getting the same result. So it tells the commutative law that when two or more rational numbers are added in different order, but we get the same result. Okay?